be able to face more.
It's time now for the Town Talker with Reverend Zechariah A. Jackson. Reverend Jackson is founding pastor of the Church of What's Happening Now, located in Plainfield, New Jersey. And now, the Town Talker, Reverend Zechariah Jackson.
Well, I tell you, it's good coming to you. You know, all this rain and things that we're facing, it's just so much that, you know, we, you know, kind of wish that the rain would stop. You know what I mean? But, you know, like everything else, you know, you can't have the flowers without rain. I planted a garden and things, so it looked like that I may get a lot of vegetables and stuff this summer, because I tell you, the way it's raining so much, you know, it's been raining since, what, Saturday or Sunday. And it's just, you know.
And the reservoirs be fed, too.
And yeah, and the reservoirs be fed also. So we just hope that, you know, everything, you know, work out all right. But I think that, you know, mankind say we got enough rain, you know, to kind of let this thing go, you know. But, you know, again, it's not our choice. It's up to the old man upstairs. So we will, you know, deal with the rain as it is.
Exactly.
You know, the other day I was looking at the Oprah Winfrey show, and someone texted me that they were giving out free chicken, you know, free this baked chicken, I think that they have, a grilled chicken or whatever. Well, that night I tried to get a free coupon, but of course all the coupons was a gone time. I tried to get on there. And today, as I was headed towards the radio station, I noticed so many people outside of KF.
It was a line.
KF's, what was it, KFC? Kentucky Fried Chicken, KFC, you know.
So they're getting business today.
Yeah, they're getting a lot of business today, but I think it's free business, Brother Porter, because it's so many, you know, I mean, it's just so much going. The line was almost like around the corner, even in the rain, you know. Mm-hmm. So, and I thought I was the only one eating chicken. It looked like it was just a multicultural line. I guess free chicken for everybody, you know what I mean? You know, just multicultural line all the way around, you know. We're on Somerset Street, North Plainfield. You know, everybody was out there trying to get some chicken. I want to. They got chicken over there. I don't know. There's somebody biting on something over there. But I don't know. The engineer room looked like, but I don't know. But today, you know, we're supposed to have Adrian Mapp, who's running for mayor in Plainfield against Sharon Robinson Briggs, but he's not here at this point. But at, we also have a brother by the name of Deshaun Porter. He's running for governor of the state of
New Jersey.
Okay, all right. Now he's running for the governor of the state of New Jersey, you understand? So now, well, where do we start? Where do you want to start at, brother?
Well, first of all, I want to thank you so much for having me on your program here today. And it's going to be a blessing to tell the people of what I want to do to help the state of New Jersey, like fighting for the poor, fighting for the homeless, fighting for the veterans that have done so much for the, not only people in New Jersey, but the people in the United States.
Okay.
So, I have some ideas that I want to share with the people in the state of New Jersey, and we can talk about that.
Okay, well, we have an experienced politician right here with us.
Oh, you know, cool, good.
A brother that's running for mayor of, we believe he's going to be the mayor-elect. He's going to be the next mayor of the city of Plainfield, Adrian Mapp. How you doing, Adrian?
I'm doing wonderful. Good to see you.
Good to see you, too. We're back in back in the saddle. This right here is Deshaun Porter. He's running for governor of the state of New Jersey. And so, you know, I think I'd bring you two together, you know, and just try to, you know, mend some things. Well, what do you want to tell us, Adrian? It's been a while since we sit down here at this stage of righteousness, I like to say.
Thank you so much, Reverend. Again, I want to thank you for inviting me this afternoon. And I want to tell the people of Plainfield that I am Adrian Mapp,
right,
a councilman here in the city of Plainfield. Okay. I'm a Democrat,
okay,
and I'm running for mayor of the city of Plainfield.
All right.
And I'm running for mayor of the city of Plainfield because there is a lack of leadership that has been exhibited from this administration. No leadership whatsoever. And this mayor has failed us miserably. And I am running for mayor of the city to bring my ideas forward. I have a vision for the city. And I want to make sure that we move Plainfield forward in the direction in which it needs to go. I have some fresh ideas, I have experience, and I have a background that I believe makes me the best qualified candidate to move the city forward at this time. And so I hold myself out to the people of Plainfield as a Democrat running for the highest office in the city. And I intend to share my vision with the residents of the city. I have a blog and a website. And I invite people to go onto my blog and website and read in quite detail my vision for the city. I will share with you some ideas this evening. And one of the things that is plaguing Plainfield is crime.
Crime, yes.
When we look at the uniform crime statistics released recently and published in the Star Ledger, crime in Plainfield has risen in the last 12 months by 12.4%.
Councilman, let me interject and ask you, since you did come out with crime and everybody, of course, is talking about it, what would be one way that in a suburban city like this here that we can curb crime?
One of the things that we must do, and one of the things that the current mayor promised to do and never delivered, is to put more police officers on the streets of Plainfield. Okay. The numbers are down. By that I mean we have less police officers on the force today than when the mayor took office on January 1st of 2006. So I intend to bring the complement of police officers up to at least 160.
At this time, how many do we have?
We used to have 151.
151.
But we have lost a couple officers for different reasons, and so we have, at most, 149.
149.
And so I intend to bring that number up to 160. We will fund that through the stimulus package that President Obama has made available to law enforcement agencies across the country. We will also fund that from the savings that will be incurred as a result of retirements and attrition. And so those are ways that I can put officers on the street to fight the crime that has been running rampant across the city of Plainfield in the last year.
Okay, everybody, of course, is talking about the stimulus package in a good manner that I've heard. Except the governor of Louisiana. I don't know what block he's on, but he don't seem to like it. Even the governor, Robin Roberts, from Channel 7 this morning, Good Morning America, was down in Mississippi. And even the Mississippi governor was talking about the growth of that stimulus package and how it would help. Adrian, after the stimulus package is delivered and we get our share, is there a way of keeping the flow of the officers on? And how will we change Plainfield and make it in more of a money making city without straining the residents? Because we've been pulled pretty thin, you know what I mean? I'm like spaghetti, you know, I'm ready to pop.
Well, it takes leadership.
Yes.
And it takes economic development so as to be able to expand Plainfield's commercial tax base to relieve the burden that our homeowners currently face and to provide the funding that will be necessary to retain the number of officers that we will need on our police department. And so I have a plan that would result in an aggressive marketing effort on the part of this city, a marketing plan that will invite investors in and will have Plainfield as an investment destination that prospective investors would want to come to. And by doing that, we would expand our commercial tax base, increase our rateables, bring more revenues into the city, and be in a better position to sustain the level of law enforcement that we need to address the issue of crime in this city.
Okay, all right. And, Governor?
Yeah.
Can't ask actually call you governor yet, but
seeing that I like it's by faith.
Yeah, Brother Porter, you're running for office now. When do this take effect, and what is the challenge that you're using at this moment?
Well, I have a vision. Thank you. I have a vision for the state of New Jersey.
Okay.
To help the people of New Jersey, because too many times we've been hurt by a budget.
Sure.
That is not only scaring to people who live in the state, job losses, school aid being cut, this being cut, that being cut. How in the world that people going to live in this great state when all the services are being cut? But what I want to do is to help college students to go to school, to be able to fund their college education.
Sure.
We need to raise the EOF funding, and we need to open EOF funding for private institutions. Some private institution, you have to go by different steps where EOF in state colleges and university, they're open to everybody. So I want to propose that EOF be open to private and state colleges and university as it already is, but bring it to the private sector so that more college students, if, should they choose to, that want to go to private school, they could go ahead and do so. Also, so many businesses are leaving New Jersey because of the high corporate tax. Well, I want to propose to even eliminate the corporate tax or even gradually lowering the corporate tax so it'd be make it easier for businesses to pay on their corporate taxes, because right now it's so much.
Mm-hmm.
It's
sure,
so much
sure.
Right now.
Sure. Okay, now that's
and also, sorry to interrupt.
Porter is running for governor.
Yeah, also, I want to call on a summit, an economic summit like they do in Washington.
Yes.
Well, this will be a summit for the state of New Jersey. We'll have politicians.
Sure.
We'll also invite the public, activists to be involved, because there are other ways for the state to make money. There are other ways to make money for the state of New Jersey so that the services could be more help for the people.
Right.
That's what I want to also bring that out.
Okay. Adrian Mapp, a young man in his prime, is taking on the challenge to become the next mayor of Plainfield.
Yes, Reverend.
Good vibes I've gotten. Bless you.
God bless you.
Thank you.
Good vibes I've gotten about you running, and people want to see change. What kind of businesses can we bring into this city that can help to lift up, you know, to erase the joblessness that's going on here? Because we're in a, I call Plainfield a suburban city. I could be off point. I don't know. I kind of think that this is a suburban city, you know. And so what can we do here? You know, what kind of jobs can we bring into this city here to kind of get the ball going?
We certainly, beyond any doubt, need to bring jobs to the city of Plainfield. Our young people are hurting. They don't have jobs.
Sure.
They are hungry for opportunity.
Yes.
And we can provide that opportunity by providing incentives to businesses to come into Plainfield, not only for businesses to come in, but for the ones that are already here to stay here and to expand. And we can use a state statute to provide a tax incentive, a rebate tax incentive to existing businesses over a 5-year period of time that, while not altering the underlying assessment, would provide them with a 5-year grace period of time to recoup their investment. And in the meantime, they would have expanded their business within the city, expanding our commercial tax base, and providing revenue opportunities.
Sure.
That will go right into the city's coffers. At the same time, they would provide jobs for our young people. Unemployment is now probably about 11 or 12%
sure.
in the city of Plainfield. And so that's one of the things that I would want to do to encourage existing businesses to expand. But we also have to provide a similar incentive to the other businesses that are not presently here.
Sure, sure.
And invite them in, and we will do that by an aggressive marketing plan, as well as me using my network to reach out and to bring the people in. Similar to what I did several years ago with the Teppers, the former Teppers department store,
sure, sure,
which had been abandoned and blighted for 25 years.
Right.
And through my initiatives, I was able to bring that back to life, and that started the revival of our downtown.
Okay, right, because I remember the vacant park that was there for so long, and then I do remember when they made it into a park, and then that didn't last, and this project we have down there seemed like it's a go.
It's a go.
It's a go. Can we build a corporate industrial circle here in Plainfield like you have if you go into South Plainfield before you go to Home Depot? I think that's South Clinton.
Yeah.
Where would we do something like that in Plainfield? Is that needed here?
Oh, it is needed. Needed very badly. And one of the things that I will do as mayor is that I will make sure that we pay very close attention to the fourth ward of Plainfield. The fourth ward has been left behind for too long.
Which is the south ward.
That is the southwestern part of Plainfield.
Okay.
And we need to do a much better job of bringing the fourth ward along and investing in the fourth ward. There are a number of brownfield structures all across the city.
Yes.
And I intend to invest in those structures by having them remediated, and I will do so by applying for federal, state, and county grants to do that. And then the goal would be to transform those brownfields into outlet shopping malls so that jobs can be provided for the fourth ward and for the city.
So the fourth ward is basically like borders Rock Avenue. Basically.
That is correct.
Okay, that right there would be ideal because we have the highway access.
We have Route 28 with all of those brownfields, and we need to begin an initiative that would lead to the transformation of those brownfields, turning them into outlet malls where people would begin to come back to Plainfield to shop, where jobs will be created, and where the fourth wall would be a part of the vitality of the city of Plainfield.
I would definitely support that idea. I would definitely,
as governor, you would support that idea.
I would support that idea if it would come to my table as governor of New Jersey. Yeah. I would definitely sign in. I have a meeting with you and the council people of Plainfield. I would definitely support that idea.
Let me ask you this right here, Adrian. Many years ago, before the current administration came into office, I remember South Side meetings. What they called, was it West Side or South Side? I used to live on South 2nd Street, not West 2nd Street, which borders Grand Avenue, Western Avenue, whatever. And we would have South Side meetings of the development of that area. And I still see nothing at this time. Can you tell me, from your own words, why have not no one made the move on redeveloping that area? Because we had many meetings. I remember many, many meetings. And I believe at the time, Mac Williams was mayor at the time. So why haven't, what happened to those meetings?
Well, the only kind of development that has occurred in this city was under the former and late mayor, Mac Williams' administration.
Yes.
The former Teppers department store,
sure,
which I made reference to earlier, and the Park Madison building. And those were the two major projects that came to life under the former administration. This current administration has not done any kind of economic development projects whatsoever. We've had a lot of talk, a lot of lip service, but nothing has been delivered. And I think it's extremely important that we create an economic development atmosphere that would not be developer-driven and developer-focused,
sure,
but would be based on the needs of Plainfield and based on our vision for what we want our city to look like. And that vision has to include input from the residents of Plainfield. And one of the first things that I will do as mayor is to appoint a broad-based commission of residents from across the city to look at what Plainfield ought to look like. And I would use that commission to help me to create a broader vision that would have the input and the support of all of the people of Plainfield. And it would include economic development as one of the pillars upon which we would build and move the city forward.
Now, I have a question, if I may ask, to the mayoral candidate. Would you support an incubation program where small businesses who want to start a business can have a centralized location like they do in Newark or Jersey City or maybe even some other parts of the state? Would you support that same initiative in Plainfield as well?
Yes, and we do have an incubator currently in Plainfield. It's located, I believe, at 321 Park Avenue, and I was supportive of it in the past, and I will continue to be supportive because I think it's extremely important that there are resources made available to assist small and local businesses so that they can become a part of the American dream.
Okay, we're going to go to commercial at this time. If that's okay, Melissa, we'll go to commercial at this time. The next question.
Veterans is multiple times higher than it is for non-veterans. The government is going to do its role, and we've got to make sure our communities and churches do their role as well. We have focused on caring, agree with the president, and as a community-based organization, we are doing our part. Focus on Caring is a non-profit organization that provides suitable and secure housing in addition to quality care living for disabled and homeless veterans. According to the United States Veterans Affairs, one out of four homeless men have served our country in the military. An estimated 500,000 vets are homeless at some time in the year. Because of one woman's desire to assist, Mrs. Eula Andrews, along with the support of her husband, has been providing services to the disabled and homeless veterans for more than 25 years in Scotch Plains, New Jersey. At Focus on Caring, we are committed to fostering a quality care living environment that allows disabled and homeless veterans an opportunity to be part of a social support network while becoming a part of an extended family. This is Grace Jones of Focus on Caring, and we welcome your support and donations. Please contact us at www.focusoncaring.org. Thank you.
Okay, we're back. And the next question, of course, and why wouldn't we ask this question, is the thing. Why haven't the current administration moved on these projects that was on the tables before this administration came into office? Before you was at the meetings, and McWilliams and many others, the development of South Second Street is still a void. Can you elaborate a little bit, Adrian, on that?
Well, there had been a number of projects that were on the table that the administration has not followed through on, this current administration. And there are a number of projects that they have floated that have not come to fruition.
Okay.
And it comes down to a very simple thing. This administration has not surrounded itself with competent leaders. This administration has gone through at least two city administrators, about three directors of finance. It doesn't have a CFO. And so because of the fact that this administration has failed so miserably to surround itself with competent, qualified people to do the job and to move the ball down the field, economic development has stalled in this city. And so it hasn't occurred in any part of the city. And one of the things that must be done is that we must diversify in terms of who we have as our economic development partner. And we should not put all of our eggs in one basket, but we must broaden our outreach, broaden our approach, and be more focused on true economic development, but we must hire competent people that are capable, that are qualified to do the job that must be done. This administration has not done that.
Okay. I have a question to stay with the economic side. As governor, I would support a legislation to keep jobs available for summer job for students while this current administration is cutting summer jobs. Would you support a summer job referendum for the city of Plainfield so that all youths who want to work for the summer can work?